I got going into this marathon cycle like in July. I just had some sort of minor like abdominal pain just right at the belt line, and with Wes Gregg, he just diagnosed like a light strain, and so he just said take the, you know, like come back as you feel okay. And we were going in the right, trending in the right direction, and workouts were going better, but just not as quickly as we would have liked. And I think the accumulation of the fatigue of just not being 100% just sort of caught up, and so I had a few pretty bad workouts. And so Coach Ben and I felt that we were looking to run either Twin Cities or Chicago, and I think it just was going to be forcing the issue. So we've kind of taken a step back and just sort of cut the running way back and just focused on getting strong through some of the weaknesses. And now still able to do one. This may be later this year, or even very early 2018. So we'll just take it kind of week by week, and then we'll either decide yes or pull the plug or worry about next year.
Once this storm is over, you won't remember how you made it through, how you managed to survive. You won't even be sure, in fact, whether the storm is really over. But one thing is certain. When you come out of the storm, you won't be the same person who walked in. That's what this storm's all about.
It went well. I'm pretty happy. Kind of disappointed I didn't run our 212 because I thought even a little earlier, like 22, I kind of started trying to dig it out because I knew I'd have to run some faster miles to get under 212, and then I think I got back under kind of if I could hold it, but I just didn't. The wind was pretty gracious. I'm still really happy with it. I'm in like kind of bummed I ended up over 212.08, I think, because I think that was the second fastest American time this year. But for me, it's a big day, so I'm very happy with it.
That was when I could tell Scott was feeling really good, and I was just trying to go with him and help him as much as possible and try to get into the last 5K. And it's weird, like, you feel so close at like 36K or 37K, but you still have, that's like 36K is still 4 miles out. Like, you can't empty the tank. And I think, like, there was just like almost nothing left. Like, I could keep running that same pace, and it felt harder and harder and harder, and I couldn't pick it up anymore. And Scott was just like so close, and I was just trying so hard to stay with him, and he just got me by a little bit. But like, that was a really good day today. That was as hard as I could run. I'm so proud of Scott. Like, it's such a tiring and gratifying experience, and it was so good to share it with Matt and Scott. I don't know. I feel so many things right now. I'm just mostly tired. It's funny that I just can't articulate what I feel right now. My legs really hurt.
Yeah, today was good for a long time. I was super windy, but I felt good for a long while, and I started to fall back a little bit. Yeah, it's kind of a bittersweet day. I mean, to come away and be disappointed with like 2:13:30 is, I mean, it's how I feel right now. But ultimately, like, after the 2 years that I've had of injury and coming back from hip surgery and missing 9 months out of the last like year and a half, completely not running, I can't be that disappointed with it. I'm happy I have two teammates today that ran 212. So now we've got four guys on our team that have run 212, which I think is, you don't see that in very many other teams or any other team in the country. So I think all things considered, it was good. It was a tough day. It's a good step, like, for me to be healthy again and just still on the way back. So I think there's still a lot of good things to come.
You know, it's hard to kind of I know what I would imagine the race is going to be like. You know, I'm going to feel great. Have very even splitting. But, you know, we'll see what happens on the day. I think as long as I feel good on the day, it's going to be a very good race. Because I'm prepared to run well. You know, you're not out there to just, like, race yourself. It is, like, kind of about beating your own personal best and, like, all that stuff. But when it comes down to it, it is kind of more about where you stack up in a field of amazing women. You know, I'm hoping to kind of knock, you know, two birds out with one stone and, you know, have an amazing race, set a PR, and ideally finish, you know, good day top 10, great day top 5.
Busy day, but that's New York for you. Picky Bars actually just landed in a grocery chain here called Fairway Market in 15 of their stores. So that was like really big for us. So they had a little event that I came to and talked about our story and did sampling and kind of had a breakfast with them and signed autographs and then came back, ran through Central Park. We did a little photo shoot for Hoka and then had a little food. Then we had a press conference over at the Tavern on the Green. And then got back, Kellen and I did a run, I got a massage, and here I am at 5:30. It's partly stressful, but partly like I enjoy it, because I love what I do for a living and that this is my job. So at the end of the day, when you're like, oh gosh, I had to have my picture taken, I had to talk to people, like that's super cool if that is what you have to do. It's like hard, because I want to be so social and I want to like catch up with people that I haven't seen in a long time, but I'm trying to just stay like tunnel vision and not and not really get too outside of my like bubble for the next couple days. And yeah, I don't know, every time like I get off the plane in New York, I have something in the air, I just like feel it and it makes me feel like home. So it's really special to be racing here. You know, I'm really excited. It's been a fabulous build up and it's been so much fun hanging on Kellen for the last 8 weeks and just putting in so much mileage and grinding some days that I didn't feel good, but there's so much like positivity in that journey that sometimes it gets sad when it's over. Like, you know, you want the race to be the culmination, but like doing the training is like the fun part, and you went through so much fatigue that it's almost like, oh, it's sad to see it go, but hopefully I can just use all that fitness that I built and, you know, put up a good showing on Sunday. Well, there's a
that we last had an American woman winning in New York. 40 years.
Place. And I was really hoping to like maintain that top five, but kind of just lost it that last 2K, but I'm still pleased with my run. I thought it was a good day and, you know, just another learning experience.
Salt water in here. It's good. Toughest race I've ever run, but I'm really proud of the effort. You know, I didn't feel 100%. But I had a couple weird things the last few weeks going on with blood work and all that, but I just tried to stay mentally strong, and you know, all the training that we do, no matter how tired you are, you just never really pull apart. So I was grateful to be able to just like keep fighting even when it wasn't going amazing. It was weird that the race went out so tactical, but it was kind of cool because then it meant that we were in the lead pack for like the first 15 miles. I think that was an awesome like point of my career that I got. So now I'm like could be in the lead pack for a long time, and I just didn't have any of the last 10K as much as I would have liked at least. But.
Okay, we got a problem. Mom, please rep this. Yeah!
I feel like this fall was exactly what we wanted because everybody ran well. Everybody finished well, nobody bonked, so the training is on point. And now we know that we can even do a little more, you know, and we can even take that next step. And Kellen was so close. I mean, she was in fourth place battling Edna Kiplagat, you know, with 5K to go in the New York City Marathon for fourth. And she had made that big move to catch up back to the pack, and it did cost her, I think, a couple of spots at the end, but who cares, you know? That's how you've got a race. I mean, I'll take that any day. And, two top tens at New York City, and it was a great fall. It was a great fall. A little bit numb, you know, because just so much emotion packed into 1 month from Chicago to Frankfurt to here.
Sit tight right here.
But it's great. And I feel very much a sense of what's to come as well, you know, already. I feel like we just got such confidence from this fall. And I watch this race and I think we can be there, you know, like there. I mean, Shalane just wins the race, you know, and we can be there on both sides, men and women, in some of these World Marathon Majors. And that's, I mean, it's just so exciting.